Dear students, greetings. I am your social teacher, Tribhura Sundari. In this video, we are going to see the first history lesson, Evolution of Humans and Society, Prehistoric Period. What is evolution? What is the meaning of evolution? Evolution means gradual development. Very slow development is called evolution. Prehistoric period, it denotes the period before history is started writing. We are living in the age of information technology. In fact, the mobile phones have put the world in our fingertips. The knowledge that we have gained did not happen all of a sudden. The foundation for this modern life was laid in the prehistoric age by our ancestors through their development of the process of thinking. Origin of our earth and the geological ages. Origin means beginning. Beginning of our earth and the age of our earth. Man's history cannot be separated from our earth's history. The upper layer of earth contains geological, archaeological and biological records of historical times. They are very important to know the history of our earth and various living organisms. All through the lessons, you often come across the word archaeology and evolution. Now let's know what is archaeology and paleoanthropology. Archaeology is a study of the past by looking for the remains and objects left by the people who lived long ago. Paleoanthropology, it is a study about prehistoric people, human ancestors and their evolution by the study of the fossil remains. What is fossil? The remains of prehistoric plant or animal that turns into stone over a period of time is called fossil. Paleontology is a study of fossils. Paleoanthropologists and archaeologists excavate the soil and rock layers on the earth and get evidence about human ancestors. Excavate or excavation meaning digging the earth carefully in order to find buried remains. Thus, it is discovered our earth was formed approximately 4.54 billion years ago. 1 billion is equal to 100 crore and 1 million is equal to 10 lakh. Gradually, conditions emerged or appeared for the growth of organisms. Then plants and animals came into being. The long span of time in the history of Earth is divided into era, periods and epochs by the geologist. And also as Proterozoic era, that is from 600 to 542 million years ago, when primitive multicellular forms appeared. Then Paleozoic era, that is from 542 to 251 million years ago, when fish, reptiles and plants appeared. Next, Mesozoic era, that is from 251 to 66 million years ago, when dinosaurs existed. Then followed Cenozoic era, when Australopithecine, that is southern ape, appeared. Australopithecines were the apes from which modern humans evolved. Now they are extinct, they are no more, but they are considered to be the close relatives of humans. Human inquiries into the past and origin of the world. The age of speculation. What is speculation? It is an idea that is formed without evidence. In the course of evolution, humans became conscious and knowledgeable. They are the only species on earth who has interest in understanding the world and the universe. They began to think and ask questions about nature, organisms and the world around them. At first, they considered nature as God. They worshipped the sun, moon and various natural forces about which they developed their own understanding, some of which is not scientific. Scientific foundations of geology, biology and archaeology. The beginning of history writing was started by the ancient Greeks. Herodotus was the father of history because the history he wrote was humanistic and rationalistic. Rationalistic, logical and sensible. Scientific thinking and enquiries started in Europe during Renaissance, that is between 15th and 16th century. Renaissance was a period in Europe when there was a surge of interest in the production of art and literature. Not only in art and literature, but many showed interest in finding the past. The scientific research of humans' origin was possible because of the interest in collection of archaeological remains and the opening of museums after the Renaissance movement. The development of ideas of stratigraphy. Stratigraphy is a study of rock layers. The discovery of human and animal fossils, stone tools and artifacts of early civilizations. Artifacts, an object that is made by a person. The ability to understand early scripts. Oldest museums. The Museum of Enigaldi Nana in Mesopotamia was established in 530 BC. The Princess Enigaldi was the daughter of the new Babylonian king Nabonidus. The Capitoline Museum in Italy is perhaps the oldest surviving museum. Ashmolean Museum at Oxford University is the oldest university museum in the world. It was established in the year 1677 AD. Herbert Spencer's Biological Evolution and Charles Darwin's Theory on Concept of Natural Selection and Survival of the Fittest helped to the scientific understanding of human beings. Darwin published the books on The Origin of Species in 1859 and The Descent of Man in 1871. Descent means origin. What does it mean, natural selection? The process by which organisms that are better adapted to their environment would survive and produce more offspring. Offspring, their young ones. Survival of the fittest is a phrase meaning the strongest will survive and the others will die and fail. In Tamil, we can say, Thagudhi ulladhu thappi pilaikum. C.G. Thompson proposed three-age system which helps to understand the prehistoric people's history. He divided the artifacts that were in Gobenhagen Museum as Stone Age, Bronze Age and Iron Age. Prehistory, from Australopithecines through Homo erectus to Homo sapiens. Who are we? What is the name of our species? We are Homo sapiens. Human evolution and migration. DNA of a chimpanzee is 98% identical to that of the human being. The chimpanzee, gorillas and orangutans along with humans are collectively called the great apes. Among them, the chimpanzee is genetically the closest to humans. The ancestors to humans were called hominins and their origin was found in Africa. The hominins emerged around 7 to 5 million years ago. Skeletons of Australopithecines, one of the early species of this tribe, have been found in Africa. The Great Rift Valley in Africa has many sites that have evidence for the prehistoric period. It is a valley-like formation that trends for about 6,400 km from the northern part of Syria to central Mozambique in East Africa. This geographical feature is visible even from the space, and many prehistoric sites are found in Eastern Africa. Human ancestors are divided into various species according to their physical features. Hominins, a geological tribe, refers to the close relatives of human ancestors and their sister species, including Homo sapiens and the extinct members of Homo neanderthalensis, Homo erectus, Homo habilis, and various species of Australopithecines. Humans are the only living species of this tribe. They stand erect, walk with two legs, and have large brains. Homo habilis, handy human, was the earliest known human ancestors to make tools in Africa about 2.6 million years ago. Around 2 million years ago, the species of Homo erectus or ergaster emerged. This species made hand axes between 2 and 1 million years ago. They began to spread into various parts of Asia and Africa. Anatomically, modern humans called Homo sapiens, wise man meaning, first appeared around 3 lakh years ago in Africa. It is believed that these modern humans finally migrated and dispersed into various parts of the world around 60 years ago. Prehistoric cultures. Prehistory period does not have evidence of writing. That is why it is called a prehistory. Already we have seen the fossil bones are classified as various species such as Homo habilis, Homo erectus and Neanderthalensis. Based on the lithic tools, cultures are assigned names as earliest lithic assemblages, old one technology, lower, middle and upper paleolithic and mesolithic cultures. Lithic means stone. Earliest lithic assemblages of human ancestors. The earliest tools made by human ancestors are found in Lomagwe in Kenya. Old one tools occur in the Olduvai Gorge in Africa. They are 2 to 2.6 million years old. The human ancestors used hammer stones and produced sharp-edged flakes. The tools were used for cutting, slicing, and processing food. Flake is a small chip removed from a large stone block called the core. Lower Paleolithic culture. The lower Paleolithic culture is marked by the human ancestors belonging to the species Homo habilis and Homo erectus. The human ancestors flaked large stone blocks and designed various tools including hand axes. These tools, which are found in Africa, Asia and Europe, are dated 1.8 million years ago. They made various tools such as hand axes and cleavers to meet their subsistence needs. These tools are also known as bifaces. Bi means two, face means side, are tools that have flaking on both sides. These tools have conveyed humans' cognitive skills or intelligent development. The hand axe tools are also known as Acheulean. This tool making tradition continued till 2,15 years to 60 years ago in India. Acheulean hand axe first recognized at a place called Saint Acheul in France. Hence they are called Acheulean tools. In India, the Acheulean tools have been found near Chennai and many more sites such as Izambur in Karnataka and Bhimpatka in Madhya Pradesh. Core is a main block of stone from which small chips are flaked by using a hammer stone. Middle Paleolithic culture. After about 398,000 years BC, further changes took place in the lithic technology in Africa. The Homo erectus species existed during this period. Lithic technology. Lith means stone. The methods and techniques involved in the production of stone tools are called lithic technology. In this period, the hand axes turned out to be much attractive in design and many smaller tools were also produced. Points and scrapers were used. Short blades were also produced. The lithic tool making tradition of the Levalaisian belonged to this period. Levalaisian tools were first found in Levalais in France, so it was named Levalaisian tools. The Middle Paleolithic culture appeared between 385,000 years and 198,000 years BC ago in Europe and parts of Western and South Asia. The tools that were made during this period were in use till about 28,000 BC. The people of this period were called Neanderthals. They buried the dead people systematically. Perhaps they were the first human ancestors to mourn death properly and bury the dead. Upper Paleolithic culture. Next to Middle Paleolithic culture, Upper Paleolithic culture. This period was marked by innovation in tool technology. Long blades and burins were produced during this time. People used different varieties of silica-rich raw materials in this phase. Numerous paintings and art objects were made. The diversity of artifacts suggests the improvement of cognitive skills and the development of languages. Microliths appeared in this phase. In Europe, humans known as Cro-Magnons lived in this period. Horns and ivory were used for making tools and artworks. Bone needles, fish hooks, harpoons, and spears were also employed creatively. The humans of this time wore clothes and cooked food. The dead were placed in the burials with folded hands placed over their chest. Mesolithic culture. Mesolithic period is known as the Middle Stone Age, as it is placed between the Paleolithic and Neolithic periods. People mainly used microlithic tools during this period, microlithic small stones. These people were hunter-gatherers. With a global warming occurring after the Ice Age, they become highly mobile and occupied various ecozones. People of Mesolithic period widely employed microlithic technology. They made tiny artifacts that were less than 5 cm in size. They produced points, scrapers, and arrowheads. They also used geometric tools such as lunettes, tools in the shape of crescent, triangles, tools in the shape of triangles, and trapezes. These tools were hafted onto wooden or bone handles and used. Microliths are stone artifacts of small size. Neolithic culture and the beginning of agriculture. The period called Neolithic marks the beginning of agriculture and animal domestication. Early proof of the Neolithic period is found in the Fertile Crescent region of Egypt and Mesopotamia, the Indus region, the Gangetic Valley, and in China. By about 10,000 BC to 500 BC, agriculture was practiced in this region. Fertile Crescent region refers to the area covering Egypt, Israel, Palestine, and Iraq, which is in the shape of crescent moon. Neolithic age is called the New Age because of the new grinding and polishing techniques used for the tools. Until the Mesolithic period, people mainly hunted and gathered food for their subsistence. By hunting and gathering, people got very limited food, as a result of which only a small number of people could exist in a particular region. The introduction of domestication of animals and cultivating plants at home led to production and supply of large quantities of grains and animal food. The fertile soil deposited by the river on its banks helped the growth of agriculture. People preferred to live on riverbanks as it was better for adaptation. As a result of domestication and cultivating plants, there was an excess food production. The surplus food production was a main factor for the development of early civilizations. Permanent residences were built and large villages emerged as a result. Hence, the development of this period is called Neolithic Revolution, Revolution Sudden Change. Prehistoric Tamilagam, Lower Paleolithic Culture in Tamil Nadu. One of the oldest Stone Age tools in the world made by human ancestors, called hominins, had been produced in Tamil Nadu. These stone tools are found near the Chennai region at several sites, especially at Adirampakkam. The archaeological excavations at the site and cosmic ray exposure dating of the artifacts suggest that people lived here about 1.5 to 2 million years ago. The Kosasthalaya River is one of the major cradles of human ancestors in the world. The people who lived here belonged to the species of Homo erectus. Cosmic ray exposed dating, a method in which exposure to cosmogenic rays is done for dating the samples. In 1863, Sir Robert Bruce Foote, a geologist from England, first discovered Paleolithic tools at Pallavaram near Chennai. They are the earliest finds of such tools in India. Hence, the hand axe assemblages were considered the Madras stone tool industry. The tools that he discovered are now in the Chennai Museum. The Paleolithic people hunted wild animals and gathered the naturally available fruits, roots, nuts and leaves. They did not have knowledge of iron and pottery making, which developed much later in history. Hand axes and cleavers are the important tool types of the Lower Paleolithic period. These tools, fitted with a wooden and a bone handle, were used for cutting, piercing and digging. The people of this time also used hammer stones and spheroids. The quartzite pebbles and gobbles were chosen as raw materials. The tools are found in the soil deposits and also in the exposed riverside. They occur at Pallavaram, Gudayam Cave, Adhirampakkam, Vadamudurai, Erumaivettipalayam and Parikulam. The Lower Paleolithic tools are also found in the North Arcot and Dharmapuri districts. The people belonging to this period used basalt rocks for manufacturing artifacts. However, the southern part of Tamil Nadu and Sri Lanka do not have evidence of Lower Paleolithic culture. Basalt rocks are igneous rocks. Igneous rocks are those formed from the molten lava from the earth. The Lower Paleolithic culture is datable to about 2.1.5 million years at Adhirampakkam. This cultural phase continued in other parts of India up to 3 lakh years ago. Middle Paleolithic culture in Tamil Nadu. Middle Paleolithic culture emerged during 3,85,000 to 1,72,000 years ago. The tool types of this period underwent a change and smaller artifacts were used. Cores, flakes, scrapers, knives, borers, levelisian flakes, hand axes and cleavers are the artifacts types of this period. Compared to the previous age, these tool types became smaller in size. Evidence for the Middle Paleolithic culture can be observed in some parts of Tamil Nadu. In the southern part of Tamil Nadu, at Pudupatti and Sivarakottai, artifacts of the Middle Paleolithic tools have been collected. Also near Tanjavur and Ariyalur, similar artifacts have been found. Mesolithic culture in Tamil Nadu. Since this cultural period occurs between Paleolithic and Neolithic culture, it is known as Mesolithic culture or Middle Stone Age. Evidence for the existence of Mesolithic hunter-gatherers is found at Chennai, North Arcot, Dharmapuri, Salem, Coimbatore, Ariyalur, Tiruchirappalli, Pudukottai, Madurai, Sivagangai, Tirunelveli and Kanyakumari. The Terri sites near Thoothukudi have evidence of microlithic artifacts. These sites have red sand dunes called terris. The people of this period used small artifacts made of chert and quartz. The tool types are scrapers, lunettes and triangles. These people hunted wild animals and gathered fruits, nuts and roots for their subsistence. Subsistence means livelihood or food. Neolithic culture in Tamil Nadu. The culture that domesticated animals and cultivated crops is called Neolithic. It is known as a New Stone Age. The Neolithic people used polished stone axes called silt. Cattle rearing was their main occupation. They lived in small villages with houses made of thatched roof and walls plastered with clay. Evidence of Neolithic village is found at Payyampalli in Vellore district and a few sites in the Dharmapuri region. Neolithic people devised the first pottery. They made pottery using a slow wheel called turntable or made pottery out of hand. Before firing, the pottery was polished with pebbles. This process is known as burnishing. Payyampalli is a village in Vellore district of Tamil Nadu. the earliest evidence for the domestication of animals and the cultivation of plants is found at this site, which was excavated by the Archaeological Survey of India. Evidence for pottery making and the cultivation of horse gram and green gram has been found in this village. Iron Age or Mesolithic period. The cultural period that succeeded the Neolithic is called the Iron Age. As the name suggests, people used iron technology. It was preceded, that is, followed by the Sangam Age. The foundation for Sangam Age was laid in this time. During the Iron Age, many parts of Tamil Nadu were occupied by people. An exchange relationship developed among the people. The people of this age had knowledge of metallurgy and pottery making. They used iron and bronze objects and gold ornaments. They used shell ornaments and beads made of carnelian and quartz. The evidence for Iron Age is found at many sites, including Adichanallur in Thoothukudi, Sanur near Madurantakam, and Siddhannavasal near Pudukottai. Mesolithic burial sites are found in the whole of Tamil Nadu. Mesolithic burial types. People created burials with large stones for the dead people. Within these burials, the skeletons or a few bones of the dead persons were placed, along with grave good including iron objects, carnelian beads and bronze objects. Grave goods are the objects placed in the burials along with the physical remains of the dead. People may have believed that these would be useful in the afterlife. Egyptian pyramids also have similar artifacts. Similar burials were also built in the early historic period or the Sangam Age. The Sangam literature mentions the various burial practices of the people. The Mesolithic burials are classified as dolmens, cist menhirs, rocket caves, urn burials and sarcophagus. The burial types of kodakkal, umbrella stone, topical, headstone and pathikkal hood stone are found in Kerala. Dolmens, table-like stone structures, were erected as funeral monuments. Cist or stone enclosures buried under the earth. They were created by placing four stone slabs on the sides, one on top of each other. The cist and dolmens have openings called portals. Urns or pottery jars and were used for burying the dead. Portals are holes found in the cist and dolmens on one side. They may have acted as the entrance to the burials. This is a view that they were meant for the movement of the soul or spirit. Sarcophagi are burial receptacles made of terracotta. They sometimes had multiple legs. Menhirs are pillar-like stones created as part of the burials or memorials. The menhirs may have been created for the heroes in the Iron Age. The tradition of hero stones might have begun in the Iron Age or even before. Agriculture and pastoralism. The people in the Iron Age practiced agriculture, domesticated cattle and sheep, and some of the groups were still hunting and gathering. Millets and rice were cultivated. Irrigation management developed in this period, since many of the megalithic sites are found nearby rivers and tanks. In the deltaic regions, irrigation as a technology had developed. Evidence of rice is seen in the Mesolithic sites like Adichanallur in Thoothukudi district and Purundal near Palani. Iron Age society and polity. The Iron Age society had farming communities, pastoralists and hunter-gatherers, craft specialists, potters and blacksmiths were the professionals during this period. The size of the burials and the variations found in the burial goods suggest the existence of numerous social groups and their diverse practices. Some of them seem to have had organized chiefdoms. Cattle lifting leading to wars and encroachment and expansion of territories had also started taking place in this period. Pottery. Pottery is an important evidence found in the archaeological sites. The Iron Age and Sangam Age people used the black and red colors to make blackware and redware pottery. Potteries were used for cooking, storage, and dining purposes. The black and redware pottery has a black inside and a red outside with lustrous surfaces. Iron technology and metal tools. The Mahalithic burials have abundant iron objects placed in the burials as grave goods. Weapons such as swords and daggers, axes, chisels, lamps and tripod are also found. Some of these objects were hafted to wooden or bone or horn handles and used. The iron tools were used for agriculture, hunting, gathering and in battles. Bronze bowls, vessels with stylish finials decorated with animals and birds, bronze mirrors and bells have also been found. Dear boys, I have given answers for 1 mark, 2 mark and 5 marks for your reference.